Good morning. Happy Tuesday. Hope your week's off to a good start. We're in Hebrews chapter 13. It's the last chapter in the book, and it's becoming very practical, very specific, very focused. And as we go through some of these things, I just want to take a step back today and note three things that are happening in this book. Just because it's important, and it's not just Hebrews. This is sort of a common pattern, a common set of assumptions that we find in the Bible, but you may not have seen it. So, first of all, it starts with right thinking. And because this is where everything is supposed to start, right? So a thought, reap an action, so that action, reap a habit, so that habit, reap a character, so that character, reap a lifestyle, so that lifestyle, reap a destiny. It starts with our thoughts. You want to control your destiny, you control your lifestyle. Want to control your lifestyle, you control your habits. You want to control your habits, you control your actions. You want to control your actions, you control your thoughts. So things start with how we think about something. And so it's important to make sure that we've got these foundational thoughts correct. Lots of people don't like to start here or don't acknowledge it. They think that thinking is very impractical. Theology is very impractical. So I'm often, if I'm preaching a theological message, arguing for big truths, people will say, well, it just wasn't very practical. I want to say it actually was the most practical thing I could do, is to try and change your big thinking about things. Look, everybody's a theologian. The question is not whether you think thoughts about God or what ultimately matters. The question is whether your thoughts are any good, and they're going to shape how you live. And while people tend to think of, you know, doctrine as being dry and dusty and not that important, as Dorothy Sayers says, the dogma, the doctrine, the dogma is the drama. This is where it all gets worked out. So we've got to think correctly. And the book of Hebrews starts by telling us we got to focus on Christ. He is God. He is the radiance of God's glory, the exact representation of his being. We've got to get Jesus as the foundation and then move on. But we don't stop there. The next thing up is that we have to actually act on what we know. Faith without works is dead. Many times Jesus will say to people who, the Pharisees, who were well-read, who had memorized most of the Old Testament, he'll say, have you not heard? Have you not read? It's a subtle little jab, because of course they'd heard. Of course they'd read. They just hadn't applied it. They weren't letting this truth change their life. Because it's very hard to change, and of course it's also very hard to understand ourselves and to see those blind spots. So look, we have to not just know what is right, we have to act on it. Faith is a verb. And so the first thing we see in the book of Hebrews is right thinking. And then we have this call to action. And then finally, there is some motivation to change. Change is hard. Look, fold your arms like this. Come on, you can do it. Fold your arms like this. Now, here's your test for today. Fold them like this. Can you do it? Now, there's nothing inherently wrong about folding our arms one way or the other. We just did it one way, and then we just did it over and over and over. So you always, generally, most people fold their arms the same way. And so that now feels right, and to fold them the other way feels wrong. And so we don't do it. It's awkward. But a lot of the things that we think are right are just, it's just habits that we've fallen into. And so because it's hard to break those habits, we often need motivation to change. And the motivation actually, I mean, keeping this incredibly simple, but the motivation is actually until the motivation to change is greater than the motivation not to change, we're not going to change. So we either have to raise this motivation up, and usually that's done through commands or creating a crisis or, you know, something we really got to change. Or it's by lowering this one, right? By taking away the barriers to change. And so in the Bible, we get both. I mean, we get invited into the life of Christ, the peace of God, the shalom, the fruit of the Spirit, right? I mean, this is what we were made for. We get invited. The more we run towards God, the better it gets. Or we are warned about what life and eternity outside of God will become. And so in this letter to the Hebrews, that's what we're seeing. We're seeing a call to right thinking, we're seeing a call to action, and we're seeing motivation to change. So it will remain practical here in the letter to the Hebrews with some housekeeping stuff as well. But have a good day. We'll talk tomorrow.